Hello learners, welcome to this program. Today we will be discussing about legal services and Lok Adalat. Why do we want to discuss about legal services in India? You know, it is said that ignorance of law is no excuse. There are a lot of cases pending in every court, and we know that justice delayed is justice denied. So we have to have provisions where if my legal rights are violated, my constitutional rights are violated, then I can approach the court of law and I can get justice within a period of time. So we will be discussing how a common man can approach court even if he has no money, he has no means, he cannot represent himself in the court of law, he has no legal education. So how will a common man get his rights upholded by the constitution, by the courts in India? So we have few provisions in this. Legal aid is a provision of assistance to people who are otherwise unable to afford legal representation and access to the court system. This is very important, you know. It is not that, you know, we have equality before law and equal protection of law as per the Constitution of India as a fundamental right. So if I cannot afford my court fees, will my rights not be protected by the law? If I do not have access to the legal documents, do you think that I cannot go and ask for justice? So even if I belong to a class where I am very vulnerable, I may be a small child, do I don't have my dignity rights under Article 21 or right to free legal aid? Yes, I do have. Many a times, you know, out of want of knowledge, a person does not know that even if he has no money, he has no resources and he is able to reach the court of law, then as a pauper suit or as a representation, he can get justice, he can get an advocate who will be representing his case, and that will not be on payment basis, but he will get it free. In terms of free, when I say, the court will pay the advocate. Just because we have a welfare state, so the court will pay the case fees, all the charges to the advocate, and the advocate will represent me. So I don't have to spend money to seek justice in the court of law. So it is said that a different system of courts is created by a new law which is called the Lok Adalat system. And this Lok Adalat system is very innovative. It has, you know, catered to a lot of people in India because court fees is very expensive. You know, every time you go up for a court hearing, it is a big lot of work. So if I don't have my means of sustenance, how will I afford to go to the court of law? So there wherein we have this legal aid provision, even if I am poor, I am vulnerable. It can be, vulnerability can be because of anything. I am a small child, I am a lady. How do I get fees to give it to a lawyer who will represent my case in the court of law? So I am a lady, I am an old person, I am disabled. Disability can be of any kind, it can be physical disability, it can be mental disability. So it can be on in terms of barriers wherein I am located in a village and I want justice. So do we have a system wherein we can get justice in a village itself, or I have to come to Delhi for justice? So these are the provisions. Then the objectives of this are very clear. You know, first is that you have to explain and understand the concept of legal aid. Because till you understand the concept of legal aid, you will not be able to realize it. Second is the historical background of legal aid movement in India. Then the main provisions of the Legal Services Authority Act 1987. Then what was the need for having a Lok Adalat? This also needs to be discussed here. Then the organization and jurisdiction of Lok Adalats. So if I say that the earlier, you know, legal aid movement started in 1851 when, you know, in France for providing legal assistance to the poor. In Britain, the history of the organized effort on the part of state to provide legal services to the poor and needy dates back to 1944. But you know, in India, when I talk about legal aid in India, have we not seen villages, you know, where we had a system that if there would have been any dispute, then there was a sarpanch, people used to go to that sarpanch and used to get justice on the spot. There are five people or seven people who are giving justice, or if we just refer to the ancient period, you just ring the bell if you need justice, if your rights are violated, and the king will come and provide you justice. So he will hear you. So that was a provision wherein you used to get immediate justice. So in India, we had just provision of legal aid, wherein, you know, it was very necessary that this legal aid comes to people on its own. It is not that I belong to a deprived class or a vulnerable class, so I cannot get justice. So we have this provision in India also. But how this legal aid movement started in India, it way back in 1952, where the government of India also started addressing to the question of legal aid for the poor. In various conferences of law, ministers and law commissions. So wherein, you know, we had this idea that legal aid should be taken up by the government of India and they should be institutionalized. When I told you about the ancient legal system, wherein if you had any query, you can just ring the bell and get justice. There was a provision wherein every village there was a sarpanch and four more people. So they used to sit together for every issues, people used to sit together and discuss. So immediate you got relief from the village panchayat. But sometimes, you know, the village panchayats were not able to provide justice in terms of the Constitution of India. So we had to institutionalize this process, wherein, you know, we follow the constitutional of law provisions, then we have different laws in the legal system. So we have to follow these and bring legal justice for all. Then in 1916, some guidelines were drawn by the government for legal aid and schemes in different states. Legal aid schemes were floated through legal aid boards, societies and law departments. In 1980, a committee at national level was constituted to oversee and supervise legal aid program throughout the country under the chairmanship of Honorable Mr. Justice P.N. Bhagwati. He was the then judge of the Supreme Court of India. The committee came to be known as Committee for Implementing Legal Aid Schemes and started monitoring legal aid activities throughout the country. You know, Justice Bhagwati, whenever we see Justice Bhagwati's judgment, we feel that he was a, you know, a judge of common people. He used to bring out, you know, laws in the interest of common people. Whenever he used to interpret the law, his interpretation was always in the interest of common people. Whether in terms of environment, whether in terms of providing justice, and he used to every time, you know, believe in the concept that, you know, India lives in villages. So if we can provide justice to a major portion or population of India, it will be a real representation of our legal system. Then we have some constitutional provisions also which talk about legal aid under the Constitution of India. Article 39A of the Constitution of India provides that the state shall ensure that the operation of the legal system promotes justice on the basis of equal opportunity and provide free legal aid by suitable legislation or schemes or in any other way to ensure the opportunities for securing justice and to ensure that because of economic or other disability, this legal aid is not, you know, it is not that it is not accessible to the people just because they are economically or otherwise disabled. Then we have Article 21, we have Article 14, we have Article 22, which also makes obligatory position for the state to ensure equality before law and a legal system which promotes justice on the basis of equal opportunity to all. Legal aid strives to ensure that the constitutional pledge is fulfilled in letters and spirit, and equal justice is made available to the poor, downtrodden and weaker sections of the society. When I say, you know, I relate Article 14, then it clearly says that equality has to be there. You cannot discriminate on the basis of caste, creed, religion, place of birth, community to which I belong, or just on the basis of gender differences. So you cannot say that you cannot be provided this legal aid because you come from this background. Article 21 also talks about legal aid in a sense, you know, that it talks about dignity and worth. How will you ensure a dignity and worth of an individual if you cannot provide justice to that person if his rights are violated? So right to free legal aid is an essential ingredient of reasonable, fair, just procedure for a person accused of an offence, and it must be held implicit in the guarantee of Article 21 of the Constitution. This is a constitutional right of every accused person who is unable to engage a lawyer and secure legal services on account of reasons such as poverty, vulnerability, etc. And the state is under the mandate to provide legal aid to that person. So this is very important. We have a welfare state. And if we have a welfare state, it is the duty of the state to provide legal aid to each and every individual, whether he is ignorant of the law, whether he comes from any other background. Then, you know, we have another justice, Justice Krishna Iyer. He also talked about development and incorporation of the concept of legal aid and has tremendously, you know, paved the way of recognizing the poor and providing him legal aid. So first is that we have to understand that, you know, the economic conditions are different for different people. The social condition, the cultural condition is also different for different people. So we cannot say, you know, that you cannot come to the court of law for justice because you cannot pay the advocates. Do my pocket will decide whether I will get justice from a court of law or not. So Justice Krishna Iyer also believed in a way that, you know, people cannot be, you know, taken away, a group of people cannot be taken away just because they are poor or they are vulnerable and they cannot afford legal battles to be won. Then it is very important that Lok Adalat is also there, and Lok Adalat has to secure the operation of the legal system, and it promotes justice on the basis of equal opportunity. And this is very important, you know, when I say equal opportunity, I have a right to be heard. I have a right to be defended. So no matter whether I am legally educated, I am literate or illiterate, I have a right and I will be protected by the Constitution of India. I have a fundamental right and also I have my legal rights. So the National Legal Services Authority is the appropriate forum wherein, you know, it has been constituted under the Legal Services Act 1987 to provide free legal services to the weaker section of the society and to organize Lok Adalats for amicable settlement of dispute. And you know, this Act, Legal Services Authority Act, was constituted to provide free and competent legal services to the weaker section of the society and to ensure that opportunities for securing justice are not denied to any citizen by reason of economic and other disability. Now, it is very important that I should know that who can get legal aid. Every person who has to file a legal aid petition He can be any person, a member of scheduled caste or scheduled tribe, a victim of trafficking, a woman, a child, or a mentally ill person. A person under circumstances wherein, you know, he is undeserved out of atrocity, food, drought, or earthquake or industrial disaster, any industrial worker. And, you know, sometimes, you know, people who have their annual income less than rupees 9,000 or as prescribed by the state government. So if you fall below a poverty line or you fall under these categories, then you can get legal aid by the Legal Aid Services Authority. Then legal services also include the rendering of any services in the conduct and case or any other legal proceeding before any court or any other authority or tribunal, and the giving of advice of any legal matter. So it is very important, you know, that first a person approaches. When the person approaches, then the Legal Aid Services Authority or the court will look into the matter, and then a person, an advocate, will be called, and he will be looking after the case of that person, and he will ensure that he gets all the updates, all the facts is known to that person, and he will be representing the person on behalf of the court. Then authorities under the Legal Services Authority Act 1987 is very important, you know. A national-wide network has been envisaged under the Act, providing legal aid and assistance. Legal Aid Services Authority is the apex body constituted to lay down policies and principles for making legal services available under the protection of Act to frame most effective and economical scheme for legal services. It also disburses funds and grants to state legal service authority and NGOs for implementing legal aid schemes and provisions. Then the composition is also very important, which is given under Section 3 of this Act. The Chief Justice of India, who shall be the patron in chief. Then a serving or retired judge of the Supreme Court to be nominated by the President in consultation with the Chief Justice of India. Then such number of other members possessing such experiences, somebody who is, you know, working in this area, will be considered by the government in consultation with the Chief Justice of India. Then after consultation with the Chief Justice of India, the central government may also appoint member secretary of the central authority. Then, you know, we have functions of the central authority, which is very important. The central authority shall perform all or any of the following functions. First is lay down policies and principles in making legal services available under the provisions of this Act. Then frame the most effective and economical schemes. This is the second function. Then utilize the funds and its disposal and make appropriate allocations of funds to the state authorities and district authorities. Take necessary steps by ways of social justice litigation with regard to consumer protection. Organize legal aid camps, especially in rural areas, slums or labor colonies, with the dual purpose of educating the weaker sections of the society as to their right, as well as encouraging the, you know, encouraging the settlement of disputes through Lok Adalat. So this is very important, you know, that you also work, you also educate people, and then you are trying that all the differences should be mediated by negotiations, arbitration and conciliation. Then to undertake promote research is the another function. And you know, it is very important that when we have to monitor, monitoring is very important, you know. Whatever programs they have to monitor whether the programs are implemented properly or not. Then they also provide grant and aid to special schemes, and this develop in consultation with the Bar Council of India programs for clinically legal education and promote guidance and supervision of the establishment and working of legal services clinics in universities, law colleges and other institutions. Then this is very important, you know, that they have to also see that they have to bring out programs wherein they are educating not only the common people, but educating university teachers, university students, college teachers, college students and the legal fraternity. Then we have another thing which is called State Legal Services Authority. State Legal Services Authority also acts as we have in center the National Legal Services Authority. So it has the same powers in the state and it also works under the direction and close supervision of High Court. Then it shall also consist of the Chief Justice of an High Court, a retired judge of the High Court, and you know the authority is also bound to you know have legal aid programs implemented, schemes in the district. So this is very important, you know, that we have four layers. First is nation, then the state, then the district, and then we have Taluk Legal Services Committee. So Taluk Legal Services is also very important as they are constituted for each taluk. So we have four levels of these committees wherein we start at the national level, then we go to taluk level. Then we have Indian court system wherein you know we can say that the State Legal Services Authority have set up their legal aid cells in jail also so that prisoners also get legal aid whenever they want. Then in Lok Adalat is a very simple system, you know. It is established by the government to settle disputes through conciliation and compromise. And the first Lok Adalat was held in Chennai in 1986. Lok Adalat accepts the cases which could be settled by conciliation and compromise and are pending in a regular court within their jurisdiction. Lok Adalat effectively deals with the magnitude of areas of cases. Lok Adalat also has helped in ending bitterness and restoring peace in family, community and locality. So you know we have a system, you know, where if you have a dispute then you can go to the Lok Adalat, because we have lot of pendency of cases in India. So if you approach the Lok Adalat, you will be able to get justice within time limit, and if you get justice on time, then this is a real protection of your legal rights and your constitutional rights. Then we have similarly state authority, district authority also, here also. And you know, when we talk about Lok Adalat, you have to have some compromise or settlement. Once the Lok Adalat takes a decision, then this is final. And if you want to have something recorded, then also you can get it recorded, and they have powers of judicial proceedings. Whenever a settlement is reached, this is called an award is made, which is deemed to be a decree in a civil court. It is to be written down in simple and clear terms, you know. No appeal is permissible against such award, which is deemed final. If no compromise is reached, the same goes back to the court. So if you have any case, then you can always say that, okay, this is my dispute. We want to amicably settle this dispute. Then if I don't want to amicably settle this dispute, then I will be going to the court of law. And if I go to court of law and you know there the court directs me that, okay, you want to discuss on this issue with the other party, so you can have this discussed in the Lok Adalat. And I wish, you know, that we have this alternate method everywhere. Today we have it in banks, today we have it in villages. So we should use these alternative methods wherein, you know, we get justice within a reasonable time. It is not that today my legal rights are violated, today you know I am a victim of an offense and I take so long years in the courts to get justice. So when I come to Lok Adalat, then the Lok Adalat has time to hear and look on my case. If I am able to compromise, you know, with the other party, then that will be written down in simple terms. It will be, you know, told to both the parties. It is not that, you know, I do not understand English and the proceedings will be in English. The proceedings will be in a language wherein, you know, I can also take part, I can understand it. And once the document is written and has been translated, if that is not my local language, then I will sign it and that will be applicable on both the parties. If you know we do not agree, then that person who is not agreeing can go back to the court of law and say, sir, we do not agree to this settlement and you know we will like to have this under the court, and then the court will take his proceedings. So this is a very good system. First of all, out of my poverty, out of my vulnerability, I will not be deprived of going to the Lok Adalat, because there are panel of advocates who are ready to hear my case, to defend my case and put my case before the court of justice. Secondly, I would like to say that, you know, it is very important that whenever you say that there is a system in place, then we should take the advantage of that system. The other way around is that, you know, you should not go to the court of law or to the Lok Adalat to waste the time and to buy, you know, more time for any proceedings. So one has to look into these things, because, you know, you go with positivity. Whenever we go to the court of law, the court expects that we go with clean hands. So if we go with clean hands to the court of law, then we will be able to get justice. And whenever we have these small issues, you know, petty issues, I will always suggest that one should go to the court of law for justice. Because, you know, if we have mediation proceedings, if we have conciliation proceedings, and we can settle out small disputes, then we should leave the courts for, you know, larger important cases, you know, where technical issues are there or where, you know, criminal offenses are there. Thank you.